Hello friends, welcome back. So in today's video, we will learn how to use Laravel's model observers to clean up our controller methods. This is done by listening to different events in the model's lifecycle. Using this method can help ensure that our classes and methods adhere more closely to the single responsibility principle. I'm going to show you a quick example. So imagine we have this page in your app, for example, an inventory of different products. After you delete this product, the app will automatically send an email to the manager that a product has been removed from the inventory. So here's the email. Of course, this is very basic for most of you here. But the point is, if we take a look at the product controller where we implement the delete method, we can also see that the only thing here is the actual delete method and some database transaction functions. The method for sending a notification by email is not declared here. That method is extracted to what is called a model observer in Laravel, where there's a class that listens to different events happening in a model's lifecycle. In this case, the lifecycle of the product model. Using this approach, we can clean up the controller methods and prevent them from becoming bloated, especially in an app that has a lot of business logic, and also adhering to the single responsibility principle, which we will discuss later. Okay, so let's get started. So first, for this example, I made a simple component for this. Here's the products table component where the delete request is made. So here's the delete product method. I used inertia here with React. So this is just a basic request to the destroy method of the product controller. Then in the web routes file, here's the products request pointing to the product controller, which is a resource controller. So if we go to that controller, in the destroy method, this is where we are going to write our delete method. Let's put it in a try-catch block. Let's say here product, delete. I'm pretty sure most of you already know this. Then let's set the exception as well. And let's use a database transaction to roll back the changes to the database if there's an exception. Okay, pretty basic. So next, let's quickly generate our mailable class and the email template. In the terminal, let's call this delete product and let's create a markdown template for the email. Okay, now back to the destroy function. Let's send the email right here after the delete function. Now, maybe in real projects, you might want to put this job in the queue for background processing. But for this example, let's just send this right away. This is not a big issue here. We'll instantiate the delete product class and pass the product there. And of course, in the delete product mailable class, we have to accept the product in the constructor method. Next, let's just compose a simple message in the email template. So let's say the product name has been deleted for the title. And then let's say a product has been deleted by a user as the message. Okay, very basic so far. So let's try this. I will delete the first item. Okay, it disappears. Now let's check the email. Now I'm using MailPit here for my local development. So here's the email. Okay, it's working. Now here's the main topic. If we go back to the destroy function, as you can see, we are sending the email notification here, right? In a very simple app, most likely it's okay. It will not be a big issue here. But as your application grows, you might implement a lot of business logic. Not only in this function, but in other functions as well. If you're not careful, it's very easy to pollute or to make any of our functions bloated by injecting a lot of functions or logic that aren't necessarily the responsibility of this method. Now, there's a software development principle called SOLID. That is an acronym that stands for 5 different principles to help us make software designs more understandable, flexible, and maintainable. The most use of which, I think, is the S part of SOLID, which is the single responsibility principle. The single responsibility principle states that a class or method should only have one reason to change, meaning it should have only one job or responsibility. In our example, the destroy method's responsibility is to delete the product. That's why the method is called destroy. It is not the responsibility of this method to send an email to someone. Of course, since this is a very simple example, you might get away with just leaving this as is. But in the real world, when things start to become more complicated, there is a big chance that you might add many business logic to any method in your class, not necessarily just the destroy method. Now, you can solve this issue by creating a trait so you can reuse the methods anywhere in your application. But let's explore another method offered by Laravel, which is called Model Observers. Let's create this class. In the terminal, we can make an Observer class. Let's name this Product Observer. And we'll need to specify the model to observe. In this case, the product model. In the editor, let's open the Product Observer class. So here we have a number of functions. We have the created function, updated, deleted, and so on. These methods represent the events that happens during the lifecycle of the model. So for example, the deleted function listens to the event when a product has been deleted, and all the logic inside this method will execute after the deletion process. Okay, so now let's transfer the mail function in the observer class. I am going to grab this, and in the deleted function of the product observer class, I will put it here. And of course, make sure that the mail class is imported as well as the deleted product class. Now, in order to make this work, we need to register the observer. So let's go to the Laravel docs, under Eloquent, and under the events, here's the observer section. And as you can see here, this is the command we ran earlier, as well as the observer class. Now, we need to place this observed by attribute on the model we want to observe. So I'm going to copy this, and on the product model, I'm going to paste this at the top of the class name, and make sure the observed by and the product observer class are imported. Now it's time to test this if this is working. In the product controller, as you can see, the mail function is no longer here. It's just the function to delete the product that is here. Remember, we extracted the process here in the delete function of the product observer class. Now, let's go to the browser and test this. I'm going to delete this item. Okay, it's gone. And yes, the email was sent and received. Let's try this again. Delete this product. Okay, it's working. Now remember, you can observe other model events, such as when you are updating or storing some data. For example, you are not limited to just listening to the deleted event of the model. Here in the Product Observer class, we can listen to other events like created or updated, for example. So let's try to listen to the created event. But this time, we are going to listen to the created event of the user model. So whenever someone registers to our application, we will send a welcome email to the user. So let's try that real quick. I'm going to create a new observer class, user observer. Okay, so here's the class. Now let's quickly create a mailable class for the welcome email. Let's call this welcome email and use a markdown template. In the created method, let's send an email to the newly registered user, instantiate the welcome mail class, and pass the user model. And of course, in the welcome mail class, don't forget to pass the user model to the constructor. Then, in the mail template, let's just compose a simple message. So let's say, welcome, new user. Delete this button and say, hi, we are so pleased to welcome you here. Then the last step, remember to put the observed by attribute on the user model. Make sure the observed by and the user observer classes are imported. Okay, and that's it. Let's try this. I'm going to log out so we can register a new user. On the sign up page, let's say the name is John Doe. Email is john@example.com. Give it a password. Okay, John is logged in. And let's see if we receive the welcome email. And yes, we received the welcome email. As you can see, it's very easy. And again, here in the user observer class, you can listen to the other events here, like the updated event. This will trigger when, for example, you updated some details of the user. And the deleted event, we saw that. And you can also listen to the restored event. This will trigger when the user was restored from being deleted, usually when you enable the soft deletion feature on your model. And of course, the forced deleted event, when you permanently deleted a model from the database. So, to recap, model observers can help us organize our code to make our controllers cleaner and more focused on their primary responsibilities, making our methods or even the entire class more adherent to the single responsibility principle. Okay, that's it guys. Thank you for watching. See you in the next video.